Ashley from Ellis. This module talked a lot about applications and installing them and everything, as well as PDFs and how to create a PDF and what you need to read those. The first question, a recent situation where I had to install or update an application was earlier this fall, about a month ago. I had to update my antivirus software, and I could either choose to renew the one that I had from last school year, which was going to cost me $50, or I could go find a free one. So I went with finding a free one, and I went with AVG, and the installation was pretty simple. It was just like a step-by-step process where you just click next and put in your information when it asks you and everything. So that part was really easy. The only issue I had was that I thought that I had completed the installation process, and it turns out I still had a small percentage left in the installing that I had left undone. And when I noticed this, it was because I wasn't having any messages pop up or anything about AVG on my computer, so that was kind of weird. So I went back to their website to check it out, and turns out I still had that little bit left. So all I did to fix that was just redo the installation and make sure that I had it 100% complete, and then it was ready to go, and it turned out being fine. So that was the most recent situation where I've installed something. And I actually have not created a PDF before. The closest I came to doing that was in journalism in high school. I was the editor for the yearbook my senior year, and we had to send off our state competitions over PDF to the state judges. And our teacher always did it, and I always thought it was because it was complicated and everything, and that way we didn't mess things up. But after this assignment, it showed me that creating a PDF is actually pretty simple. It's just a few clicks and you're done. So that was, I always thought it was a lot more difficult than that. I thought that you had to like convert things over from application to application, and that it was just this huge drawn out process, but it turned out to be very simple. I think that as a future teacher I'm going to use that a lot. And I think it can be used to improve communication with particularly parents, to send documents and important letters and everything over email to parents and make sure that they're all able to open it. Also, obviously, it can improve communication with colleagues and students as well, not just with parents. Another way that you could use that, I think, is showing examples to students. Like in presentations, you can use a PDF to show it as a picture, kind of like as a PDF file, instead of showing them the actual website or the actual application. And I think this way you can show them what it's going to look like and where they're going to click without actually being on the application itself. I have had to record myself before for classes, so I have used the webcam. And it was kind of the same setup as this, but it was like an introductory video. And then also I had to use it as an assignment for my foundations class last semester. We had to film ourselves teaching a lesson for fake students or whatever, to put together a lesson plan and everything. So I haven't ever had issues with the webcam. I figured it out pretty quick on this computer. You just go to the application itself and it's built in and everything's already ready for you to use. So that was pretty simple. And the only issues I've ever had is uploading to YouTube. Sometimes it gets complicated and drawn out, but that's only if the download takes a really long time, which usually it doesn't. It just probably depends on your connection. So I'm pretty familiar with how to do that. And I think making the videos is helpful because I think you can use it to reach out to students in the future as a teacher and be able to show them step-by-step processes without having to actually physically be with them. So if they aren't there for class, or if they forget how to do something, they can go back on the website and find your video and do it and watch it at home, so they can see how they're supposed to do their homework or whatever. So I think the webcam can definitely be a tool that's used a lot in the classroom as well. Anyway, I learned a lot this week about applications and PDFs, and I'll for sure be able to use this information in the future.